In this video, I will be explaining anatomy of triceps brachii. I will explain its origin, insertion, function, then important landmark with triceps brachii. Triceps brachii is on backside of your arm. So this is your triceps brachii. Actually, there is no other muscles on backside of your arm, so it's very easy to recognize. Let's look at its origin first. Triceps brachii has three heads. That's why this is called triceps brachii, right? We have long head here, the longest fiber. And you see kind of tiny blue spot here? This is medial fiber of triceps brachii. And this red one is more on the lateral side. That's why this is lateral head of triceps brachii. Let's look at the long head first. Long head actually attaches on the scapula. The name of this place is infraglenoid tubercle. Infraglenoid tubercle. It attaches on the scapula. This is very important. I will explain why this is important later. So, the medial part and lateral part attach on the humerus. They originate from humerus. Then, these fibers attach on here, right here, elbow, right? So this place is called olecranon process. Olecranon process, that's an anatomical word. Then you remember these attach on elbow. So the main function of triceps brachii is elbow extension. This is extension. This is flexion and extension. Triceps brachii is very strong elbow extensor. On the other hand, what is strong elbow flexor? It's biceps brachii, right? Triceps extensor, biceps flexor. So here's elbow joint, it extends the elbow. But there's one fiber which does different thing. What is it? That's long head. Why? Because it attaches on scapula. What was it? Infraglenoid tubercle. So since this fiber attaches on the scapula, that means it crosses shoulder joint. That's why long head does shoulder movement. What are they? So the one movement is shoulder extension. See, when I move the shoulder joint, the long head kind of slacks, right? This slack means, in reality, that means shortening. When muscle shortens, that means this is contracting, right? So, shoulder extension and one another movement. You see the direction of fiber? Because of this little bit diagonal fiber, it does slight adduction, very slight. Adduction is a closing arm. So, long head does, of course, elbow extension, then extension of shoulder and adduction of shoulder joint. This is very important. Long head is different from medial fiber and lateral fiber. So, I will recap. The origin of triceps brachii. Long head attaches on infraglenoid tubercle. It's part of the scapula. The medial part and lateral part attach on humerus. Then these fibers insert on olecranon process, which is elbow. Then these three fibers do elbow extension, right? And long head does extension of shoulder joint and adduction of shoulder joint. In next part, I will explain the important part of long head of triceps brachii and other tissues. So I changed the position of skeleton. Now you see more colorful tips here. Now I will explain what these are. So this red one is long head of triceps. There are no medial head and lateral head on this model. Red one, triceps brachii long head. The green one is teres major. The blue one is teres minor, which is part of rotator cuff. These three muscles are important for posterior part of shoulder. Then, you see this kind of small space here? This kind of rectangular space? This is called quadrilateral space. Quadrilateral space. Quadrilateral space is organized by four structures. One is long head of triceps brachii, especially this part. Then, teres major, teres minor, and medial part of humerus. So by these four structures, this rectangular shape, quadrilateral space is organized. Then you see this yellow tape? This represents one nerve. This is axillary nerve. This is very important nerve because this innervates teres minor and deltoid muscle. And it gives sensational branch for shoulder joint. If one of these structure gets tight or disability or injury, like you got a fracture here or dislocation, tight teres minor, tight teres major, or triceps brachii, it will shorten this space. Then it may pinch axillary nerve. Then you may have pain around here. That's why long head of triceps brachii is important for posterior part of shoulder joint. Why? Because this is one of structures which make quadrilateral space. This sounds very interesting, right? And one more thing. I personally use triceps to palpate two nerves. One is axillary nerve, of course. Then there's another nerve deep to here, which is radial nerve. I didn't prepare the radial nerve here, but it's running like this way. You see the pain here? Radial nerve is running like this, and you can palpate radial nerve through this space. So I personally use triceps brachii to palpate these two nerves. I cannot emphasize enough, triceps is so important, of course, for elbow movement, shoulder movement, and for lat work. In this video, I explained the basic anatomy of triceps brachii, its origin, insertion, the function, and anatomical structure involved with triceps brachii. So this is today's video. If you liked it, please like, comment, and subscribe. See you in next video.